light hangs lost in space. Over the long gone century, the rain falls torrentially and soaks into war-scorched earth crust. Eventually, the wind howling like a hammer, battering the landscape and making plain the strange beauty of a blank slate. The palace claims mandate, it dominates with languid angers. It cranes its neck of stone to scan for ramblers. Eyes on the canvas, sculpted in the scene, a lonely cloaked figurine seen drifting through the night and clinging tightly to the tiny living shrine of golden light within her clutch. Unwavering focus channeled into one pivotal moment where the opus culminates and us begins again. Hold tight, or all the rest is desolation and the cold night. She'll come so close until swallowed by the cipher. Single soaring solar to the sun that almost seemed for a brief interjection through the effortless perfection of her essence to have challenged architecture of oppression and trusty old chaos. Reared its face through the paint gloss. Rarely takes a day off, so she seeks her shelter in the wild again, a child again, the mother of us all. Shunned and shamed in all her holiness, a hooded refugee of ancient myth, the city civilized rage fades further into distance in the mist. And yet, there was a lightness in her stride even now, as if she'd heard the song no voice could sing, and harps upon the winds again, a symphony that lingers in the wings of them, the ones she called akin, last pride of the tribe. There was the two of them, if only for these few and precious moments, and the amulet of jade engraved in daylight. Only thing remaining of her past, aside from access to compassion, as a bastion of the sacred, suspended, isolated, iconic imagery devices. The mother and the child and the greatest of all sacrifices. She the symbol, the antidote to ISIS. Cut loose by Osiris. Collective respiration now staggered, if only for a brief shift, the pattern's always open to interpretation still. The rain and the wind and the plantations and the hills and then only barely visible, the squinted gaze, the dimmest ray of light piercing the night began to emanate. The same flame scorching at her heart, now their devising was reflected dutifully on the arc of the horizon. On loop, a tansual mantra and a head around her neck, that utmost sacred of all hand-me-downs. She stands aground, even as the land is drowned. They glimpse the green glint against the gloom, engulfed in the glow, a gladiator goddess bearing gifts.